when you have such kind of rapport, then you'd have this case where someone leaves, you're not sure of what's happening, and you've been exploited.
Hey, welcome to the FinTech Frontlines by Kora. This podcast is a collection of timeless ideas on how to build, launch, and operate a fintech in Africa from the most experienced minds in African fintech. In this episode, Emmanuel Opara, the engineering lead at Coda Business, discusses the processes and systems businesses can build to prevent extra employees from creating loopholes or backdoors into their systems.
How do you prevent such situation from happening where an engineer leaves the company and they create loopholes into the system where they can use to enter or break into the system? How do you prevent such scenarios?
Okay, yeah, thank you very much for your question. So I think first off, this is actually a rather interesting point because many times as a company, without, you know, a proper process, people tend to skip things like this, because as engineers, you could have access to developer tools, which we definitely have at some of your testing environments. But one of the things that we do here is we basically have a process, right? It's more like an onboarding process. If you're having to leave an organization, one of the things we ensure we do is to disable access to, more like from a central place, so everything that you could actually be able to access. So things like even as little as your email, or down to communication tools, or down to some developer tools. And then if there are cases where you could have some thumb tokens to some APIs, then those tokens are changed. Unfortunately, we've not had this, an experience of someone or an ex-staff exploiting an API that they basically had access to in the course of the working relationship with the company. And like I said earlier, this is something that without the process, one may actually get wrong, especially for startups. You know, as a startup, you might get too engaged into having to grow the company, scale up and whatnot. You have so much of a focus building systems. So many a times you have many of these companies lose sight of this, the need for such process to be put in place. And when you have such kind of loophole, then you'd have this case where someone leaves, you're not sure of what's happening, and you've been exploited. Yes, well, I've had cases where someone had to leave and then I had to try to put my head on the ground to be sure that there is absolutely nothing left, even while I know that there is a process in place to cater to things like this. But yeah, I think that's what I can just say with respect to this.
Thank you for listening to this episode of the FinTech Frontlines. For businesses that are bullish on Africa, Kora provides all the support you need to start and scale with delightful payment products for collections, payouts, and settlements. Learn more at korahq.com.